I'm Ron Patterson with Utah State University Extension in Carbon County. About 3.5 years ago, I planted these peach trees and had 6 trees left over. I didn't know exactly where to put them, so I planted them with the intent of moving them somewhere. And about 3 years later, I finally got around to putting them someplace else. So this spring, with these 3-year-old trees, I got them transplanted and had 100% success rate. Right here, I have one of these transplanted trees that actually even produced fruit this year. And then you can see behind me on this other side, that's what the original tree would have looked like. So it does shock them down a little bit, but if you need to move a tree that's not too large, you can do it by hand. So this video will show you how to do that. When you plant a tree, normally you want to make sure that, well, always you want to make sure you're planting it where you want it, but sometimes you find out that you just planted it in the wrong place. These peach trees that I've got here, I've got some of them that I just planted and I've just decided that they're not where I want them to be, and so I'm going to transplant them. They've been here about 4 years, so chance of success is somewhat limited, but if you follow some of these basic rules, your trees will have a better opportunity to be successful if you follow these basic rules that I'm going to talk about today. Now, some of the tools that you will need are, you'll need to have some pruning tools, like a loppers, a pruning handsaw, and some hand pruners, because when it all boils down to it, you want to have balance between the roots and the top, and you're going to cut out away a lot of the roots, especially if they've been here for as long as 4 years. If I were to wait any longer, I probably wouldn't dare to do this, but I think that I can be successful if I'm very careful. But I want to make sure that the top is going to be balanced with what's left of the roots. Another tool that will be handy to have is a trenching spade. They're very nice, very handy. They get a good narrow, you can get down deep with your blade. That's a good tool to have for this particular job. And then when you're ready to move the tree, you'll want to have a tarp to wrap your ball, your root ball in, to keep it from falling apart when you're transporting it. And then it really helps to have, this is a little bigger than I need, but this cargo netting is good, tough material that I can slip underneath that root ball, and if it's not too heavy I can lift it myself, or these are going to be fairly heavy, so I'll probably have someone help me lift these up out, get them transported, and set them back down into the hole. So those are some of the tools that you'll need for this particular task, and I will show you kind of a step by step. We'll start with pruning the tree down to hopefully balance things out. When you prune, you want to make sure you maintain your scaffold branches. I've had these here for a while, and I've tried to train them so that they will grow the direction I want them to grow. So I normally, when you prune, you don't want to take out more than a third of the top in any 1 year, but because I'm going to take out a lot of the root ball, I'm going to want to take out at least 2/3 of this growth that is going to be here for this next season. So here it is, mid-March, the weather's pretty good, the soil's not frozen, and fortunately I don't have really rocky ground here, so the digging won't be too bad. So first off we'll start pruning this tree down and see how we go from there. Make as few a cut as possible. So you want to prune out, take the big cuts. If you take out the big cuts, you decide what you want to keep. If I wanted to keep 3 scaffold branches on this tree, I want them to go in different directions. I could keep, 4 or 5, but beyond 4 or 5 is really not very useful. I've got 3 really good branches that are pointing in different directions, so that's what I'm going to keep on this particular tree. I like to have them growing out. Peach trees like to have a little bit of an open center to them so that your fruit will ripen well. And so I'm going to prune out some of these minor scaffold type branches and then keep the 3 main branches, which I'm going to keep. This branch, and this branch are growing all out in 3 different directions, giving me pretty good balance to the tree. So we'll start with those. Now notice I'm supporting these branches as they come off so that they don't tear a strip of bark down the trunk. That's always not a good thing. So you can use loppers, you can use hand pruners. These are probably the right size that I can use loppers. You just get your loppers in there. Snip those right off. We've got this scaffold branch, and that scaffold branch, and they're all really quite nice, but I've got to take off a lot more material. So as I think through this process here, a lot of these pencil branches from last year's growth would normally be some of my fruiting wood, but because I'm going to transplant this, I'm just going to take a lot of those out and not really worry about fruit on this particular tree this year. I get up to a point where I say, okay, I want to direct this branch out a little bit more maybe. And I've got a pretty good branch going out this direction. This one's going more up, and I want to open it up a little bit more, so I will take off that one right there. You do the same thing here. When you cut these branches, you want to make sure that you cut down to a branch that's no less than 1/3 the size of the main branch. So if I'm going to cut back to here, I don't want to cut back to this tiny branch here. I want to cut back to something that's going to be at least 1/3 the size of the branch that I'm removing it from. This one's a bit more of a challenge here. And where I've got, where I'm going to take a lot of the root off here, I may just go ahead and remove this branch right at this point and keep that branch coming out that direction. I'm still thinking about it. I kind of think as I prune, the other thing to kind of consider when you're doing this is to think about the maintenance. Is it going to be hard to keep these maintained? Now granted, I am taking a lot of material off of this tree, but like I said, something that's kind of got to be done if I want to give this tree a chance to survive the process. Take off these little pencil branches. I don't know if pencil branches is an official term, but that's kind of the size you're looking for when you're pruning your peach tree for the fruiting of the current season. So that's what I call them. I've got one that's kind of right up through the middle. I want to make sure I take that one out. Anything that's going back towards the middle, I'll take off just because. Any hangers that are sticking out the bottom of the branch, I'll take off. But I'm taking off a lot more than they normally would prune off these trees. Okay, well, I've really decided that I don't want to take this branch off, or this one. I like the balance that it gives the tree, so I'm going to leave them there. I'm going to have to prune pretty seriously going up to that point, or after that point. Probably six or seven of these pencil-sized branches on each one of these scaffold branches for your fruiting. These peaches will fruit on last year's growth. I'm not worried about fruit on these trees this year, so I'm just taking them. Well, hopefully, next year or two, I'll be able to get these branches growing a little bit out more the direction I want to, so we'll get maybe some of these branches growing out this direction a little bit better. And I'm almost done here. Some of these tips of these branches look like they might have to be pruned off a little bit later in the season. It's definitely a lot different looking tree. Again, it's more than I'd normally try to do on my pruning, spring pruning, but this is a different situation, so we'll try it from that point and see if this tree will survive its transplant. Now, before I get too carried away, I want to point out one thing that's very important is to make sure that you compass your tree. In other words, you orient it to the sun, especially if it's been out in the environment for a few years like these have, you orient it to the sun the same way in the hole where you plant it. So I have this little tag that I'm using for some research, but I put it on this south-facing branch, so when I get it planted again, I can have this branch facing south again, and it will be oriented the way it needs to be. It's another thing to consider when you're transplanting trees from one spot to another. Now, this transplanting is something that you don't want to try to do when the leaves are out. You want to make sure you do this. It's mid-March right now. It's a pretty good time. The reason I'm daring to do this right now is because typically in the spring time, the soil starts to warm up, the roots will grow before you start getting vegetative growth. So I'm hoping that by transplanting these now, getting the roots to grow a little bit, cutting back the top a lot, I'll have balance and I'll have some root growth that, before there's a big demand on the roots, will have some new fresh roots growing. When you're digging, you're not going to be able to carry a really big ball of soil, so you're looking at about 12 to 15 inches away from the trunk of the tree is about as big as you're going to be able to handle. When you dig, you want to dig sideways or parallel to the trunk. You don't want to dig into the trunk this way because that will break away the ball. You can't really dig this way, so it's better if you can dig parallel to the trunk of the tree. And you're going to come across roots. When you do those, just break off the roots on the root ball side. Like I said, there's roots growing all out throughout this area, and it's just something you're going to have to do. So that's another reason to prune these trees away before you get started, so you can kind of work underneath them. Again, you want to be careful to not use the root ball as a, try to not use the root ball as a prying point. Otherwise, you'll break that root ball up and cause more problems. I'm going to bevel the hole just a little bit for the lip of this hole, so that eventually I can get down underneath and sever the roots that are coming out the bottom. So I'll clear some of this away. Okay, one thing to keep in mind is, of course, I do have a place picked where I want to plant these trees. Don't just dig them up and think, okay, now what do I do with them? Make sure you've got that place picked out so that you can move them. Now, I'm down deep enough that I can undercut and cut those roots that are going out below. You can also, to lighten the weight just a little bit, shave some of this topsoil off. Chances are it's kind of built up. Something you want to pay attention to right here at your collar, your root collar. You want to make sure that when you plant back to that location. Don't plant it deeper and don't plant it shallower. It probably survive a little better if it's shallower than if you planted it deeper, but it's important to try to get back to this level right here in the soil. This tree is about ready to start undercutting some of this topsoil off so that we've got a little bit less weight when it starts packing it. That's another nice thing about these trenching spades, is that you can get under there pretty good. Again, I'm being careful to not pry against the ball so I don't break that root ball up. Okay, now I can start tipping this, and I'll tip it gently so I can sever the roots underneath a little bit more easily. All right, looks like we're broken free now. Now that root ball is probably 150-200 pounds, so I may want to prune off some of these roots. Some of these roots sticking out may snag a little bit on my tarp or my cargo net. So I'll prune them off a little bit smoother. All right, it's ready for the tarp and the cargo net. The purpose of the tarp here is to keep the root ball from falling apart, just to kind of hold it together while we're transporting the tree. So if we tip it over, that tarp underneath there is a wad under there. We would gently tip it back. Now to hold the tarp in place so it's good and tight, you can use some 16 or 18 penny nails and just kind of pull that up tight, peg it down, just peg it into the root ball will be enough, into the soil. Together pretty good. Might pull up a little bit more right there. Now we want to do basically the same kind of a thing with the cargo net. I wish I had one that was a little bit smaller, but you work with what you've got. An edge along here. So we'll do the same task, bunch that up underneath. All right, that one's ready to go and there's no way I'm gonna lift that myself. So now I gotta wait for my helper to get here. South part facing south, and I'm trying to take out the tarp and the cargo net at the same time. So notice that although I prune these trees very heavily, I did leave the terminal buds on the branches that I've got here, and those will help to encourage the roots to grow. There's a hormone released in those terminal buds that will encourage the roots to grow, and that will help us to have more successful transplant. The final step is to stake your tree. So one of the important things to pay attention to when you're staking your tree is to not have the cord too tight. You want a little bit of slack in that cord so that the tree can flex in the wind. That will help the tree to strengthen the wood. So you want to make sure that you've got some slack in there, allows the tree to bend a little bit, toughens up the roots, and then don't tie your string, twine, whatever you're using, don't tie it so tight that you girdle the tree. You only really need to stake them for about a year. After that, there's really not much point in having the stake on there. So you stake according to the prevailing winds. If your winds come from the south, then have your stake from the south. Here I've got my tree staked. I've got two stakes coming to help protect from the strongest prevailing winds from the northwest and from the southwest to help these trees stay in place until they can get strong enough to stand on their own.